In this video, I'm going to take you through our new front door, literally. Our old front door dates back to when the house was built in 2001. Using the term dates back does make it sound like an archaeological artifact. The door was getting on a bit, and cosmetically it needed a paint and general spruce up. However, structurally the door was okay. But why did we decide to change it rather than simply painting it? In December 2020, and again in March 2021, I used my thermal imaging camera to view the door from the inside and from the outside of the house. And it was an enlightening outcome. These are the shots I took in March 2021. This is the shot looking from the outside, and here's the thermal imaging of that same view. Now, it has to be said, I'm no thermal imaging expert. If you spot anything I've missed or got wrong, then please do jump into the comments down below. The house will be around 20 degrees centigrade on the inside with the heating on. Outside temperature was around 7 degrees Celsius when this photo was taken. Using the thermal imaging camera to find missing insulation and energy losses, the difference in temperature between the inside of the building and the outside of the building should be preferably about 10 degrees centigrade. The brighter the colour, the more heat. The darker the colour, the less heat. So for example, the doorbell is on the right hand side of the door frame, about halfway up. It has an illuminated bulb which is sort of always on, so it gets hot. And this is the hottest area of this photo at 13.2 degrees C. If you look at the bottom of the door, you can see where we're losing heat. It's leaking out under the bottom of the door, represented in yellow and with some green edges. Yellow means more heat, whereas green is slightly cooler, or less heat. The wooden panels either side of the door are losing heat too. They show up as a greeny yellow colour. Note it has a yellow band around the green. There is greater heat loss in the yellow area due to the scalloping moulding design of the centre panel. This is the thinnest part of that panel. The glass is obviously transparent, so it can lead to false outcomes, so ignore the big red area in the centre of the glass, because that's the inside of the house. I suspect the two glass panels are losing heat anyway. They are double glazed, but only just. They have a very thin air gap of about 5 mm between the two panels. Also, looking around the edge of the door, it meets the frame at the top and the sides, you can see yellow and green again, signifying heat loss. Same with the letterbox positioned in the middle of the door. The only good bits are the brick walls and the bottom panel of the door, which I suspect has an insulated core. This is from the inside looking back at the door, and here again is the thermal image of that same view. This is the same day, same time of day as the images that we've just looked at from the outside, which means the internal and external temperatures are the same. Here we are looking at drafts coming into the house. Notice the blue areas indicating drafts coming in from the outside. Look at the bottom of the door, and on the right hand side near the floor, a very cold spot there. These images visually demonstrate that we needed to improve the thermal efficiency of our front door. Once our attention was drawn to the inefficiency of the door, on a windy, cold days, we noticed drafts coming in under the door, through the letterbox and around the door seals. The wooden side panels and side windows with a thinner double glazing were significantly colder to the touch than the main door and its glass. Many people have decided to sort of build a porch on the front of their house to improve the thermal efficiency and reduce drafts, which is a very sensible option. However, we didn't want to do that as it would spoil the front aspect of the house. I didn't want to lose the current look of the building line of the front of the house, which meant a porch was a non-starter. As I'd already been researching EnerPhit retrofits to passive house standards to make our house more thermally efficient, and if you've not seen that video, I'll put a link to it up here and also a link in the description down below. It was a bit of an easy leap to start looking at entrance doors that met passive house standard, so I started researching thermally efficient doors. After looking at many, many websites and manufacturers, I found RK Door Systems. As the BBC says, other door manufacturers are available. This isn't a paid advert, I'm not getting any incentive, purely my findings as a paying customer for the product. What I liked about these doors was the wide choice of design and features. You can create a one-off bespoke door that you design yourself, adding and removing items, sort of fittings, features, options. It truly is a custom door that no one else will have. They use German-made components and aluminium profiles. Their doors are PAS 24 certified as well as secure by design. A PAS 24 2016 is a British Standard Institute method for assessing the security performance of external doors and window types. Apparently, one of their customers was ram raided by a 4x4 and the door held up. The laminated glass, toughened glass held up, basically none of it gave way. Secure by Design is an initiative developed and owned by the Association of Police Officers. The purpose of Secure by Design is to incorporate crime prevention into the design of doors and window products. The door we chose has a U rating of 0.72 watts per meter squared Kelvin, which is a bit of a mouthful. Typically doors are a lot higher than that. So it is very impressive in terms of its thermal efficiency. The door has flash interior and exterior, which means there are no visible hinges. It's triple glazed, and the door and frame is 75 millimeters thick. There's also an online door designer for arcade doors. You can configure your door and choose what options you want and what it will actually look like. You can actually upload a photo of your own house and place your chosen door in the location to give you an idea of what it will look like, both from the outside and from the inside. And you can also get a quote online. We opted for a site survey and for RK to install the door. We then placed the order, and there was an 8-week wait for the door to be made. The door was delivered 2 days before the installation team were due to arrive. They unpacked the door and checked it over with me to make sure everything was okay. The installation day arrived, and obviously it started raining, despite it being dry and sunny for the days beforehand and the days afterwards. But I guess that's just how it seems to work. The two guys from the installation team, Seth and Clive, basically over the course of the day, they removed the old door, making very little damage to the plasterwork surrounding the door on the inside. The new door was installed. It's a really heavy aluminium frame in one piece. And once it was installed, it was then bolted in place. The glazing was installed and trimmed to complete the look, and it was then sealed. And they did a great job of installing the door and created very little mess, cleared up after themselves, and talked us through what they were doing while they were doing it. They were very, very neat and tidy, even down to sort of finishing off the bottom edge of the door with a wooden, an oak trim to match our floor. Once the team had left, we set about filling in the plaster around the inside of the door where there'd been some damage. This was then painted and caulking applied to finish off the look. And we're basically really pleased with the door. Not only does it look good, but now it's like you can shut it and you shut out all the noise from outside. Not that it's particularly noisy, but if it's like windy or stuff like that. So both the triple glazing and the door thickness means that the hallway is much quieter. Something we've not really thought about, really, about the noise. As I say, not that it's noisy where we live, it is a quiet cul-de-sac, but even so, when the neighbour's kids are playing in the street, or there's delivery vehicles coming and going, or it's like really windy, you just basically can't hear anything now. Closing the door is like closing a bank vault. It's a very satisfying experience, kinesthetically and orally. We also opted not to have a letterbox, as this makes a big hole in a thermally insulated door. They actually do matching letterboxes, so you can choose a door design if you want to and have your letterbox matching your door. However, we'd already had an old cast iron red letterbox that we purchased from a reclaim yard some 20 odd years ago, So now that is our letterbox. And the postman loves it. We're looking forward to the winter, bizarrely, for those cold, windy nights. As we know, the hall will be warm and toasty now. So that basically completes another piece of our jigsaw puzzle to improve the thermal efficiency of our home. So if you've got any questions, please drop them down in the comments below and I'll pick them up. Thanks for watching and I'll see you on our next video. All right, take care. Bye.